Hello, dear students. I welcome you to the online classes of Blooming Bird Square School. We are studying Chapter 2, Contours, and today we are going to study our topic drainage system. In exams, you will be given a topo sheet. On that topo sheet, you may be asked one question, that which type of pattern this drainage system is having. Right, whether dendritic, trellis, radial, centripetal, or disappearing. Right, so in this lecture, we will learn how to solve those type of questions. Right, so before going to the patterns, let us first understand what are drainage systems. Drainage systems means the water which pours on earth in the form of rainfall, right, or snowfall on mountains, that comes down from the high altitude land towards the low altitude lands, and finally it meets with the sea. So the small streams at the higher level of land, suppose on mountains or on top of mountains, they meet with each other and form bigger streams, right? And they flow in particular pattern, right? That pattern may be radial or trellised, right, or dendritic or centripetal. Any pattern may be there. Okay, so the flow of water from higher lands to lower lands, and finally when it meets with the sea, right, that we are going to study today. So in our drainage system, when the river emerges from the source, we can say here, if some mountain is here, so the origin point of river is source, and the final point of river is mouth. Here, suppose it is mouth, river mouth. So from here to here, river can be broadly categorized into three, its course can be categorized into three parts. The first part is upper course, or mountainous course. When river flows on mountains or hills, that course is called upper course. On mountains, as gradient is very steep, slope is very steep, so that is why the speed of water flow is also very high. And because of that, downward cutting, or you can say vertical erosion, takes place most on the mountainous or mountains or hilly areas, right? Downward cutting is most. And as we know that the slope is steep, when slope will be steep, what will happen? That will be represented by, you can say, dense contour lines. Okay, suppose if one valley is there, and through that valley one river is emerging, so it will be like this. Okay, 1900, 1800, 1700, and 1600. This is the highest point, then 1800, then 1700, and 1600. From here to here, the height is decreasing. So slope is this way, right? Slope is this way, and from here this way. So river is flowing this way here. You can say here and here like this. So river will be flowing this way. Clear? Here I have shown you that these contour lines are closely spaced. Why? Because the slope is steep at the upper course of river A, right? Let me just zoom it. Okay, so can you see here this picture clearly? This is 1900, 1800, 1700, 1600. This river flowing is represented by here, the slope, steep slope has been represented by contour lines, and contour lines are closely spaced. This is the symbol of river here, right? So it is showing that, okay, this is the upper course of river. Then the middle course or the plain here, this is the middle course of the river or the plain. Here contour lines are widely spaced, 1500, 1400, 1300, 1200. Here at the middle course, lateral inversion, or you can say, it's not lateral inversion, lateral erosion. Lateral erosion means the erosion from the sides. The river cuts its banks a lot, okay, and its width become more than the than in upper course. So here lateral erosion is higher, and here land is a little bit flat, flatter than the mountains, okay. So that is why the contour lines are widely spaced. Why? Because here slope is gentle, not steep. And at lower course the river becomes sluggish, right? And what happens here, the land is having very gentle slope, and because of that these contour lines are widely spaced, not closely spaced, okay? So it is more wider than this, right? Widest, it is less, this one, middle one is plain, this one is mountain, and this is lower course or delta course, you can say. So the river can be divided into three courses: upper course, middle course, lower course. Upper course at mountains, lower course plain, and upper course mountain, middle course plain, and lower course delta, right? Now we will study about the pattern in which water flows. So the pattern in which water flows is called drainage pattern of river. Here, as you can see, I have clearly shown five types of patterns: dendritic, trellised, radial, centripetal, and disappearing. Now, what is dendritic? Dendritic means if the water is flowing in this manner. Suppose this is a river, right, coming here, and water is flowing like a branch of tree. This type of pattern of river flow is called dendritic, okay, where so many, you can say, sub parts, or river is divided into so many parts, or just like branch of trees. Then second is trellised. When a river is forming, flowing this way, right, this is a main river, and various tributaries join it at 90 degree angle. This is called trellised pattern. This is A and this is B. Trellised or trellised pattern. This trellised pattern, this is the main river, and these are the tributaries. These tributaries are joining this main river at 90 degree angle. What is the angle? 90 degree angle, right? So this type of pattern is formed by river, where alternative layers of soft and hard rocks are found, okay? So this type, if water flows, if river flows in this type of manner, then this type is called trellised drainage pattern. Then third is radial pattern, right? Radial pattern, suppose if there is a volcano or a mountain or volcanic mountain, right, or a mountain. So from here the water will flow in all directions, right? Water will flow in all directions from a center, right? This is called radial pattern. Again, I am drawing one more picture for this. Suppose water is flowing this way, 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 from this point, right? This is called what? Radial pattern. See, this is radial pattern. Clear? Then centripetal pattern, centripetal drainage pattern is just opposite to the radial pattern. When the water flows towards a common center from all direction, that is called what? Centripetal pattern. This is D. Centripetal pattern, right? Centripetal pattern. Now, here you can see clearly water is coming out from center, and here water is flowing towards the center, right? Maybe it may be a depression or a water basin or a lake, right? When water will flow towards the center? When the center will be having lower altitude than the surroundings. Okay, land from surrounding should be higher. That then only the water will flow towards the center. Clear? Now, the last one is disappearing drainage pattern. So this disappearing drainage pattern is this one pattern. Suppose this is a river flowing, right? And what happens? This is the river flowing and it disappears. Right? It disappears. So, the pattern in which a river get disappeared, that type of drainage pattern is called disappearing or inland drainage pattern. This type of inland drainage pattern or disappearing drainage pattern is found in deserts, right? So it was all about the drainage patterns. You will have to remember these patterns. One questions may be asked. Okay, you just need to remember all these things. These types of patterns will be made on topo sheet. Okay, and you will have to see it clearly whether it is trellised, whether it is dendritic or trellised, or it is radial or centripetal, or it is disappearing. Okay. The perennial rivers are shown in blue color. Non-perennial rivers are shown in black color. This may be the symbol. This is supposed symbol, right, of river. In blue color, it should be in blue. It means it is perennial. If it is in black, it means it is non-perennial. If it is like this and then dotted, it means it is disappearing river. Clear? So this was all about drainage system and drainage pattern. Now our last topic is the conventional signs. Conventional signs. So conventional signs have been given in your book. I would like to show you here and explain you. Just look at that. Just give me a second, please. Here you can see clearly, these are the symbols and conventional signs. This is the symbol of fort, this is church, tomb, pagoda, graveyard, chhatri, mosque, battlefield, temple. So these are the symbols, monuments and buildings. These symbols belongs to railways. These symbols belongs to road. Here you can see metal road. They have shown by parallel lines in red color. Here you can see metal road with kilometer stone. Here this is 20 is showing us kilometer stone. Here you can see 20 is showing us kilometer stone. This is pack track. Pack track means pagrindi. This is car track where only carts can move. These are the bridges. These are the air transport. here this is road with bridge, bridge with piers and causeway. You must have seen some bridges, okay, like bridges on rivers, and you see there that big iron pillars are there, okay. Those types of bridges are called bridge with piers, right? And this is a causeway. Causeway means suppose one shallow river is there, and through that river there is a road also, okay, that is called causeway. Now this is air transport, communication, drainage systems. Right here you can say perennial river, they have shown like this. Dry stream or non-perennial river, they have shown like this. River with islands or delta, you can say, right? If it is triangular, then it is called delta, right? If it is round, then it is island, you can say, right? Then this is tidal river. Tidal river means the river which is connected to the sea, where tides occurs frequently, okay, where water from the sea get into the rivers, right, on high tides. Then these are the dry river bed with water channel, okay. This is river bed, means the broad area of river. When there is rainy season, then this entire area, in this entire area you will get water, okay. But when during dry seasons, only this much stream, in this much stream only water will be available. This is called dry riverbed with water channel, and this is dry riverbed with relative height 6 meter, okay. Here this is dry riverbed, and here the height of the bank is 6 meters, and here canal is connected to this perennial river, okay, canal perennial, and this is canal non-perennial. These are the means of irrigation: dam with masonry work, dam has been pakka dam is here, this is kacha dam, dam with earthwork. Sorry. These are tidal streams. This is line well, this is tube well, this is unlined well. Line well, pakka well, unlined well, kacha well, right? And this is dry tank, talab, okay. This is perennial tank, the talab where water river remains available, okay. And then tank with embankment, this tank is here, okay. And embankment means you can say some wall type structure constructed in order to stop the flow of water out from this tank. Then tank with water and broken ground, spring, embankment, these all are the symbols. You can see these symbols have been shown in your book very very clearly. Just go through these symbols, and if you are not getting meaning of any of these things, you can ask me, okay. Then there are some Hindi names used in survey maps, like nadi, river, nala, small streams, pahad, hill, parbat, hill or mountain, piao, a place where drinking water is available, generally along a road or at railway stations. This is like water tankies are available. Piao is available, like one is on Raisati near medical, okay. This modern type of piao is you can say that water cooler, okay. Now police chowki, talab, khela, kiln or baking bricks, the place where the bricks are baked, that is called khela, okay, to which we call bhatta, okay. Then tehsil or taluk, dak bungalow, a government owned bungalow for travelers to stay for a night or two. Now colors used in maps: black color is used for names, lines of latitude and longitude, and survey trees, heights and their numberings, river banks, broken grounds, dry streams, railway telephones, telegraph lines. Blue is used for water related figures, perennial rivers. Green for forests, grasslands, orchards, scattered trees. White for rocky or badlands, uncultivated lands. Yellow for cultivable lands. Brown for sand features like sand dunes, sand hills, contour lines, foam lines and hills. Okay, red for grid lines, eastings, northings and man-made features such as road, car tracks, buildings, huts, etc. So this was the second chapter of the book which I have already taught you. Contour lines. This chapter is completed. We have studied two chapters so far. I hope you would have understood this. Thank you so much.